Okay, so today I want to make a special tray. So this is the primary cast of a mandibular, partial mandibular case. It's a Kennedy Class 3 Mod 1, although that gap there, you may think about actually not putting a tooth in that gap, but certainly need some teeth in this gap. But I want to make a special tray because this is from a primary cast. So a special tray. First of all, we're going to need some wax, a tungsten carbide carver, and a wax knife and a pen point for this. Going to begin by drawing on the extent that I want to make this tray to. So I want to be full sulcus depth, indicate full sulcus depth with the pencil. About there. And then I'm going to take this impression in alginate, so I want this to be a spaced tray. So I'm going to use two layers of wax. First layer. I'm going to heat in the Bunsen. I don't want to make this wax too hot because I don't want it to thin down too much. I want it to try and retain its thickness so I can gauge the thickness of space that I'm going to place on this. I'm going to apply half, fold it over. On that side, fold that side over. Trying to get down to full sulcus depth. That's those inside bits. I can see where the pencil line is, so I'm just going to trim that the excess off there. Pencil line on the inside. The little bits that I'm missing here, I'm just going to fill those in now. Again, just with one thickness of wax. A little slither there that needs to be put back in as well. So that's the first layer put on, roughly put into place. Next layer. So I'm going to use two layers because I want the alginate to be used in a section of about 2.5 to 3 millimeters. So two layers of wax will be about that thickness. Next one gets adapted down again and fold over. And I'll just thin that down a little bit at the front because I want to just get it two layers and no thicker really. So I've just got a little bit of work to do at the front there to thin that down. And we'll trim this down to the layer underneath. Trim a little bit off this thickness because it's a little bit thicker than two layers there. And that's good now, so that should be quite a uniform two layers of thickness all the way around. That's going to give me a nice spacer. I'm now going to use a light cured acrylic light cured blank. Okay, so that's the base plate down. I'm now going to use light cured acrylic. I don't want to thin this material, I want to keep it pretty similar thickness to what it is now. That way it won't get too sharp at the peripheries. So we'll start off by applying it onto the lingual aspect. Then try and fold over. And you can see it's just a little bit short in those areas, so the bits that I'm going to cut off here I can add to that. So we can, we're always alright adding little bits to this because it will stick. Trim the excess off there. Make sure that's adapted down. And we can just add that little bit at the front as well. So I'm only roughly trimming this away. We're going to trim this later with a tungsten carbide burr. I did a little bit for the handle. You can put all sorts of different types of handles on this. I prefer the handle that comes out away so it gives me something to hold. What I want this handle to do is not to impinge on the lip in any way. So when I'm taking the impression, I can manipulate the patient's lip and tissues, and this isn't going to impede taking a good impression. So I want the handle to come out the centre of the ridge, up and slightly forward. Now I'm going to perforate this for retention, and it's easier now just to put the little holes in with a burr. It saves time later. I don't want to put the holes too close to the periphery, but I want to make sure that there's plenty of perforations in there. If I put it too close to the periphery, I can sometimes make it sharp when I'm trimming it up later. Okay, so that is roughly how I want it to be at the moment. I'm going to put it into the light box and cure it for 5 minutes. Okay, so that's been in the light curing box for 5 minutes. I'm just going to remove it from the cast now. If I just gently remove it, it should come away. And this one is taking all the wax with it, which isn't a problem because I can strip that off later. So I'll just get rid of this excess wax out of here now. And just gently remove it. Once you get some of it to come away, it should just all lift up. So sometimes it's still a bit soft in here, which this one is, so I'm going to put this back in the light box now and cure the underneath. So I'm going to put it in like that and cure this side of it again for another couple of minutes just to make sure that it's completely cured. Okay, so that's it cured now. You can see all the edges are still rough, all the perforations are there, but they're not all the way through, and the handle's looking quite rough. So I need to trim it all up now using a tungsten carbide burr. What I'm looking for is something that's going to be This is the extent that I want. I don't want it beyond that extent. So I'm looking for, when this is pushed on there, I want to be able to just see that line. So when this is pushed all the way down to the teeth, I want to still to just be able to see the line. So I'm going to trim this now. And I'm going to use... I'll use something a little bit bigger than a tungsten carbide, actually, do it quicker. I'll just turn the extraction on. So I'm just checking where the attachments are. Lots of relief for the frame attachments. So you can see here's not too bad, a little bit overextended here and here, and a little bit at the back there, so I'm going to trim a little bit more off this. Okay, so I just want to make sure that these perforations are all opened up to the correct size. So on the inside, I'm just going to touch these with a burr. Just make sure all the edges are nice and smooth. Okay, so that now, once I put that on there and it's lifted up for the impression material, it is ideal for the borders now, so it's not overextended anywhere, and that's going to allow me to use about 3 millimeters of alginate, which will take a good impression for this area. I'll just rinse that away and get rid of all the residue, any wax residue that's underneath here. So I'll rinse that with boiling water, and that's a special tray, space special tray.